Listening Library presents Payback on Poplar Lane by Margaret Mincks. Read for you by Monika Felice Smith and Christopher Gebauer. For Scott and Maddie. Notice of silent period. Dear Poplar Lane, thank you for supporting my extremely successful business, Star Maps of Poplar Lane. It's been a pleasure making high-quality maps, starring you, the fine citizens of our cul-de-sac. I've learned so much about your lives, careers, and square footages. As my mentor, Tom Reddy, once said, part of being great at business is knowing when to move on. So I've decided to sunset Star Maps of Poplar Lane. That means I'm not doing it anymore. Don't worry, this isn't goodbye forever. I'm taking a silent period of 1 week to cook up my next big project. It's a recipe for success. And the can-do attitude of Peter's U-inflate self-service tire pump, the artistic flair of Peter's porch selfie station, and the streetwise sophistication of Uber Peter's textbook transport wagon. Put them in a business blender, makes one serving of my next smash hit. Fortunately yours, Peter S. Gronkowski. Founder, CEO, CFO, and COO of Peter Presents, Inc. P.S. You are cordially invited to attend my corporate launch party next Friday at 4 p.m. It's in my garage. I predict there will be a huge announcement about an exciting business opportunity just for you. This is your chance to be a leader. Don't miss out. P.P.S. Yes. There will be Peter Presents Inc. cupcakes. PPPS. No, there will not be lemonade. Business tip? Lemonade is for amateurs.
Be yourself. Poplar Lane Middle School's Self-Abration Self-Portrait Contest. Instructions. Show us who you really are. Draw a self-portrait below. Prizes. Winner will receive a coupon for one mega freezy shake at the Cone Zone, limit one topping. His/her picture on the front page of the Poplar Middle School Daily Chronicle and membership in Poplar Middle School's Random Acts of Artness Club. Winner will also reveal their self-portrait and address the school board at the next Poplar County School Board meeting. It's your turn. Name, Rachel Chambers. Tell us about yourself. A picture is worth a thousand words. That's what my dad says. Draw your self-portrait here. I drew a picture of a turtle. Chapter 1. Rachel. I peeked outside my house to make sure no one was looking. On this cul-de-sac, someone is usually looking. The path to the mailbox was clear, so I tiptoed over. Inside was a smushed construction paper cat sculpture and a thin white envelope with my name on it. I knew what it was. The results of the Poplar Middle School self-portrait contest. Boom, boom, boom. My best friend Clover banged on her bedroom window. She lives across the street. I got my letter too! I'll call you, Clover yelled. Her voice was crystal clear, even though the window was shut. Dr. Spumoni says Clover has excessive earwax. Unless she gets the wax flushed out once a month, she can't hear herself talk. Dad says Clover and I are best friends because opposites attract. She's obsessed with cats. I like dogs, and my earwax is fine. We're like two peas in a pod, but the pod is kind of warped and uneven. I'm the smaller, quieter pea. I hurried inside and answered the phone. Clover squealed. Let's find out at exactly the same time. One, two, I won, she said just as I was unfolding my letter. Disqualified. The word screamed at me in thick red marker, right on top of my drawing. This is not a self-portrait. It's a turtle. I didn't, I said. My face felt numb. There was something extra pathetic about being disqualified from a self-portrait contest. I read the directions again. Show us who you really are. Draw a self-portrait below. They never said you couldn't see yourself as a turtle. I'm not the only one who thinks I'm a turtle. At the last parent-teacher conference, Mrs. Francis told Dad I needed to come out of my shell. Why? The world is noisy enough. Maybe more people should stay in their shells. Oh, no, Clover said. She sounded horrified, like it never occurred to her that if she won, someone else would have to lose. Clover always wins. She wins so much that I'm her official victory speechwriter. It's practically a full-time job. It's okay, I said. I like the cat sculpture. Clover makes me a new piece of animal art every week. Most of the time it's a cat. Thanks! I'm experimenting with glitter, Clover said. She's always experimenting with glitter. Anyway, cupcakes! What cupcakes? Peter's party! Didn't you get the invitation? I didn't say anything. Oh, Clover said. She stayed quiet for one whole second. I bet he meant to... It's okay, I said. Sometimes I say things are okay without even thinking about whether it's true. Peter Gronkowski had been my next-door neighbor for our entire lives, and he still didn't know I existed. It's hard for people to remember you when you have a best friend like Clover. Come to the party with me, Clover said. You can be my date. I sighed. Okay, I said. If I didn't go, Dad would probably make me read a book on engaging with my peers. Oh, I have to give a speech for the contest, Clover said. Can you help me? I'm kind of busy, I said. But I guess so. Thanks, Rach, Clover squealed. I held the phone away from my ear. You're the best! Click. Dad says I'm like a guy in an old play called Cyrano de Bergerac. Cyrano was a really good writer, but his friend got all the credit because he said Cyrano's words out loud. One time I Googled Cyrano de Bergerac. He had a gigantic nose. Ew. And was in love with his cousin. Double ew. Does that sound like a compliment to you? The reason I'm kind of busy is a secret. It's such a big secret that not even Clover knows. The only person who knows is not a person. It's my dog, Molly. My secret is that I'm writing a book called Cyrano's Revenge. In my book, Cyrano is a girl with an average nose. She's tired of only helping other people. She wants to shine on her own. Just because I'm quiet doesn't mean I don't have anything to say. There were three signs on Peter Gronkowski's front lawn. One said, "Launch party this way," with an arrow pointing to his garage. The second was a picture of a rocket with a caption that said, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, countdown to success. The third was a drawing of a lemonade pitcher with a red X through it. What do you think Peter's new business is? Clover asked as we walked into his garage. An alien-human student exchange program? I guessed. Ah! Clover's laugh bounced all over the garage walls. One good thing about having a loud best friend is that she laughs extra hard at your jokes. Making jokes is one of my secret talents. I only make jokes with Clover, Molly, and Dad. Once Clover told Mrs. Francis I was funny, and Mrs. Francis laughed because she thought that was a joke. Peter's garage was already packed with kids from the cul-de-sac. Most were crowded around the Peter Presents Inc. cupcake tower. The PP frosting logo on each cupcake was starting to melt, so the display was looking a little slimy. A big sign read, Peter Presents Inc. Cupcakes, to be eaten only after the huge announcement, and only if you have a green wristband. Best, Peter Gronkowski, founder, CEO, COO, and CFO. Drool, said Clover. Peter's mom is a cupcake genius. Yeah, I said, but I could see Mr. Gronkowski through the door at the top of the garage stairs. He was wearing a white apron with chocolate stains on it, and Mrs. Gronkowski was at work. Conclusion, Mr. Gronkowski was the cupcake genius. Before I could tell Clover my theory, Ken Spumoni ran over. He was wearing a black t-shirt that said security. Hey, Clover, Ken said. Don't forget to write your essay. He pointed at a crystal ball with a sign beside it that said, Peter Presents Inc., Crystal Ball of Opportunity. One essay equals one cupcake. Essay? Clover asked. She wrinkled her nose. Like school? Not really, Ken said. He looked down at his clipboard. The topic is, why do you want to work for Peter Gronkowski? I don't, Clover said. Do you want a cupcake? He asked.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.